Hello dear students, a very warm good morning to all of you. So we are discussing our organ system, that is what? Circulatory system. So from the circulatory system, today we will discuss about the next circulatory organ, that is nothing but and very important circulatory organ, that is what? Human heart. Okay, so the human heart is a very important function which plays a vital role in the circulatory system. Okay, so this human heart is act like a pump. Okay, so as we are having the water pump in our house, it helps to remove the water from the well and helps to transport it into the tank which is we are kept on the over the slab, okay, or on the top of our building. Okay, so in this way, this human heart continuously pumps the blood throughout our lives. Okay, so let's see about the human heart. Okay, so human heart is pinkish and is about the size of a fist. So the human heart is the basically pinkish color or organ, and the size is about the fist. Okay, fist means what? This is our palm. If we will close it, it is called as what? Fist. Then almost roughly the size of our heart is this much. Okay, next one is that it is hollow, highly muscular, cone-shaped structure. The human heart is hollow. Hollow means what? There is nothing inside. There is a hollow place inside it. It is hollow, highly muscular. It is the made up of so many muscles, like that we can say that highly muscular and a cone-shaped structure. Okay, so here we can say that I have drawn the roughly diagram of the human heart. It is the mostly the cone shape. Also, it is hollow and muscular part of a body. Okay, next one is that located in between the two lungs in the rib cage. Okay, so it is very important. We are telling that the heart is located between the two lungs. These are the lungs, and between the lungs there is a heart, like this we can say that. Okay, so the heart is situated at the center, okay, between the two lungs in the rib cage. But the lower tip, okay, the lower tip slightly tilt towards the left, okay, but the lower end of the heart is slightly tilt towards the left, we can say that. Okay, so this is I am having the structure of the heart. This is lower tip of the heart is little towards the left side, and that is the reason we can feel the heartbeats to the left side. But the heart is situated in the center of the rib cage. Okay, next one is that it consists of the four chamber. Okay, the human heart is having the four chamber, which are that two upper that are having thin wall, and they are called as what? Auricles. Okay, so the human chambers are, human heart is made up of four chambers. The upper chambers are called as what? Auricles, and they are having the thin wall. Okay, and the two chambers which are what? Lower chambers. Okay, two lower, they are having the wall, that is what? Thick wall, and they are called as what? Ventricles. Okay, so the two upper chambers are called as what? Auricles, and two lower chambers are called as what? Ventricles. Okay, so see here, you can see that left auricle, right auricle, left ventricle, right ventricles. Okay, so the auricles are the two upper chamber, while ventricles are the two lower chambers. Okay, and the auricles are having thin wall. Auricles are having thin wall, while ventricles are having thick wall. Okay, while the ventricles are thick wall. Okay, so why these are the auricles and the ventricles are present in the heart? Because as we know, the heart can transport the oxygenated blood also and the deoxygenated blood also. It means what? It can transport the pure blood also and the impure blood also. Okay, so to avoid the mixing of this impure and the pure blood, there are the chambers present, that are what? Auricles and ventricles. Okay, that is the reason the auricles and ventricles are present in the heart, to avoid the mixing of the pure and the impure blood. So let's discuss about now auricles. Auricles is nothing but what? Two upper chambers are called as what? Auricles. Okay, so these auricles are also known as what? Atrium. The auricles are also known as what? Atrium. See here, you can see the upper two chambers of the heart are called as what? Auricles, or it is also called as what?
atrium. Okay, it is also called as what? Atrium is the singular. Singularly, we can call as what? Atrium. These are the two upper chamber. They have thin wall and receive blood from different parts of the body. Okay, so these atrium, or we can say these auricles, receives the blood from the different parts of the body, and they are having the thin wall. Okay, so these auricles have thin wall and they receives the blood from the different parts of the body. Okay, next one is that the right auricles receive the impure blood. Okay, very important, keep in your mind that the right auricle receives the impure blood. Okay, so here you can see that the right auricles receive the impure blood while the left auricle receives the pure blood. Okay, left auricle receives impure blood while left auricles receives the pure blood. Okay, so this is about what? Auricles. They are also known as atrium. They are the upper chambers of the heart. They have thin wall and receive the blood from the different parts of the body. Right auricles receive impure blood while the left auricles receive the pure blood. Okay, now we'll discuss about ventricles. Okay, so the ventricles are the lower chambers of the heart. Okay, ventricles are the lower chamber of the heart, or the lower chamber of the hearts are known as ventricles. Okay, next one are, that is, ventricles have thick walls. Ventricles have thick walls to pump the blood out of the heart to different parts of the body. Okay, so these ventricles are having the thick wall. Okay, why the ventricles are having the thick wall? Because these ventricles pumps the blood from the heart to the different parts of the body. Okay, so this ventricle pumps the blood out of the heart. From the ventricles, the blood from the heart comes out. Okay, and that is the reason they are having the thick walls. Okay, next one is that there is a thick muscular wall is present, or there is a thick muscular wall between the auricles and ventricles, and that thick muscular wall is called as what? Septum. Okay, this thick muscular wall is called as what? Septum. So there is a thick muscular wall is present between the two auricles and between the two ventricles, and that thick muscular wall is called as what? Septum. Okay, and because of the septum, the hearts get divided into left and right side. Okay, so the septum divides the heart into left and right side. Okay, septum divides the heart into left and right side. Okay, so these are the two parts, or these are the two main parts of the heart, we can say that what? Auricles and the ventricles. With the help of the two auricles and two ventricles, human hearts are having four chambers. Okay, so this is all about today. Today we have discussed about the human heart. Here we will stop. We will meet in the next video, and for today, thank you.